Welcome into the Chiefs Report. I am your host, Harrison Graham. Thanks to everybody who submitted your questions on our last video, on our community post using hashtag Chiefs. That's your easiest way, your best way of getting your question on our mailbag. So let's kick things off with Monster Jam Fan 0311 using hashtag Chiefs. Should we draft a cornerback with the number 32 overall pick? Like Marcus Peters, obviously he's referring to the last time the Chiefs took a corner in the first round back in 2015. Kansas City historically doesn't take corners in round one, only two since 1992. Peters, of course, 5 years ago. These are the top five draft prospects. Obviously, Jeff Okuda is probably not going to be an option, as he's going to be a top five pick more than likely. Christian Fulton, CJ Henderson, Jeff Gladney, Trevon Diggs, I think those are more the players you're looking at here. I find a hard time believing Fulton falls to the bottom of round one, but if he does, as I mentioned on a previous video, I think that would be a home run draft selection. Those other players are good options there as well. I think cornerback's the biggest need for Kansas City. Kendall Fuller's a free agent, Mo Claiborne, Bashaud Breeland, all three of those guys set to hit free agency. I think Kansas City will try and keep Fuller and Breeland, if not at least one of them, but cornerback is still a need. Not sure Rashad Fenton is ready for a super big increased role, although I do think he will play more in the 2020 season. What do you guys think? What position should the Chiefs target at pick number 32? You might get hit with a YouTube ad break. If you do, scroll on down. This will be the pinned comment. Answer this question. What position should the Chiefs target with the 32nd pick? John Carter, as we keep things rolling here, should the Chiefs trade the number 32 pick for more draft capital in round two? A lot of draft questions early in the video. Obviously, the last person said drafting a cornerback. John is saying, should we trade back? I do think trading back is an option for Kansas City because they don't have a sixth-round pick. They don't have a seventh-round pick. Only five picks in total. Obviously, last pick of round one, they got the 49ers pick from the D4 trade in round two after they traded their second-round pick for the Frank Clark acquisition a year ago. Third, fourth, and fifth, those numbers can change based on comp picks. So we'll see where the third through fifth round picks actually come in once the comp picks are demonstrated. But I do think trading down is an option. I think it's a good option if you don't feel like a very good player is on the board at number 32. Get some extra picks and stock up on draft capital. Should Kansas City trade out of round one? Type Y for yes, type N for no. What do you guys think? I think it just kind of depends on how the draft plays out, right? I mean, certainly if there's good opportunity to move up, that is an option. Stand pat, take a corner, take a linebacker at 32 or a wide receiver. I think you could do that as well. That's how this thing goes. It's just too hard to say a couple of months in advance. But what do you guys think? Should the Chiefs trade out of the first round? Well, that was a question. This shouldn't be. Chiefs Super Bowl gear on sale. If you're kind of on the fence, like, yeah, I don't know if I want to spend any money, this stuff is 30% off, up to 30% off. You're not going to find better deals out there. Chatsports.com/ChiefsSB to get your Super Bowl champs gear on sale. We got different style hats. We got different style hoodies, long sleeves. I'm not showing you every style we have because if I did, we'd be here all day. There's hundreds of Super Bowl champion items with our partner Fanatics, up to 30% off. Check the comments, check the description. The link will be in there for you guys. And then you just click on it, boom, you get right to the website. You get this stuff up to 30% off. Take advantage of this deal today. Tatum Floyd is next up. Dude, I gotta tell you, the Lions are open to trading their pick. It's true. We trade out 32 and Sammy Watkins and take Isaiah Simmons third overall. A lot to unpack here from Tatum. Let me simplify this for you and for everybody else. Sammy Watkins is not a great tradable asset. So him and the 32nd overall pick, not getting you to number three. Look, Detroit, yes, they're open to trading down because the top two picks are clear. Joe Burrow's going to go to Cincinnati. Chase Young's going to go to Washington. Kind of drops off a little bit after that. So Detroit's kind of in an interesting spot saying, hey, we'll trade down. A team wants to trade up, draft Tua or something like that, we're certainly open to that. GM Bob Quinn spoke on that recently, saying he is open to any trades. No conversations have taken place yet. That would expect to heat up over the next couple of months as we lead up to the end of April with the NFL draft. Detroit would like to get more draft picks to bolster that roster. They're kind of in rebuild mode at the moment. Again, this is Tatum's trade proposal. Watkins and the number 32 overall pick for the number three pick. It's not going to happen, Tatum. This is probably what it would take. Number 32, your first next year in Chris Jones. I mean, that's probably what it would be to move from 32 to number three. Maybe not another first, maybe it's a second, but Chris Jones is really the only player the Chiefs have that they could possibly be willing to give up that is going to give you that much draft capital. So Sammy Watkins, if someone wants to trade for him, great, get out of that contract, but you're not moving up to number three just by dumping Sammy Watkins. Now, Isaiah Simmons would be a whole lot of fun on this defense. If the Chiefs could figure out a way to get him on board, I'm down for it. Tested extremely well at the combine, can play basically every position on the defense. I think he's a roaming linebacker at the NFL, but can play some safety, he can play some corner. I think he's going to be a good option rushing the passer at times as well. Freak athlete. I think he's going to be an excellent player for wherever he ends up in the NFL. All right, Chiefs fans, channel continues to grow, about 1,500 subscribers. I think we just hit the mark before we film. Let's get to 2,000, youtube.com/ChiefsTV. Hit that big red button if you're watching on our Chiefs channel. If you're watching on our main chat sports YouTube channel, link is right down there below. We're going to have the latest rumors, news, free agency, and draft coverage for the next several months leading up to the 2020 season as the Chiefs try to repeat. So go ahead and subscribe. Join us on this journey. Keep the questions rolling here. Let's talk to Eric O'Connor using hashtag Chiefs. Will Chris Jones play under the tag? Got a couple of Chris Jones questions in here. I think there's a pretty good chance, unfortunately. Look, we all want a long-term deal for Chris Jones, but as you guys know, Kansas City placed him under the tag so no one else could swipe him in free agency. Doesn't mean the Chiefs don't want to sign him. Doesn't mean the Chiefs can't sign him. But we know the cap situation. It's not great for Kansas City. Now, the latest projections is that his salary cap hit under the tag would be $16.1 million. Pretty good value for a guy like Chris Jones. He's looking for $19, $20 million per year on a long-term deal. So if Kansas City doesn't like a long-term agreement from Chris Jones and his agent, they might just keep him on the tag. And obviously, he'll hold out, I'm sure. He held out last year up until training camp. We'll see how it plays out this year, but I do think there is a good chance he plays under the tag in 2020. Here's another Chris Jones question from Amir Salim. What are the chances we get Jones under contract before the start of the regular season? I think there is a chance. I think there's a better chance he plays under the tag, as I previously outlined, but look, you want to keep this guy long-term. The last 2 years, this guy has taken off. He's played in a 3-4 scheme and done well in 2018. Switched to a 4-3 in 2019, put up 9 sacks in just 13 games, and in some of those 13, he was not nearly 100% healthy, dealt with injuries all year long. He is a rare player that can blitz from the inside and the outside. Really good pass rusher. Not great against the run, but certainly not bad either. Obviously, the Chiefs want to keep Mike Pinnell also, but Chris Jones, very, very good player. One of the top players that would have hit the free agent market had he not been franchise tag. Obviously, the Chiefs decided to do so. So what's going to happen in 2020 for Chris Jones? If you think he's going to play under the tag, type one. If you think the Chiefs and Jones will come to a long-term deal, type two. Could they go the D Ford route? What we saw last year, tag and trade. If you think that's the option, type your three down below. I think one's actually the most likely. I think the order it's in is the most likely. I think play under the tag, then new deal, then trading him. I think trading's more of a long shot. I do think it is an option, so go ahead and cast your votes down below. Aaron Calishaw is up next using hashtag Chiefs. Should the Chiefs be looking at another speed receiver or a bigger, more physical receiver? So first, let's take a look at the depth chart, obviously. If and when, and I say when because I think it's pretty likely, Sammy Watkins either gets cut or traded if Kansas City finds a trade partner. That leaves you a bit of a need at receiver. Look, you like the rookie Mecole Hardman, but Demarcus Robinson's also a free agent. I don't expect him to come back unless his market dries up. Byron Pringle did some nice things last year. I don't know if he's ready for a super bigger role. Maybe he's ready to be your wide receiver four. I don't think he's a starter, though. So you lose Sammy Watkins. Obviously, you need another receiver, whether it's in the draft or in free agency. Now, if you want to go the speed route, here are some free agent options. Robbie Anderson, I think he's going to cost too much, but he's fast. He can go deep. Philip Dorsett could be a cheaper option, as would Taylor Gabriel. Nelson Aguilar, he drops everything, but he's fast, and occasionally he makes a good play. You could get him for cheap. Tavon Austin, kind of a gadget speed type of player. Think a little bit more polished DeAnthony Thomas. That is what you would be getting in Tavon Austin. Some draft options for speedy wide receivers. Henry Ruggs III, you'd have to trade up for him. He's not falling to 32. Jalen Reagor probably will be available at 32. Didn't run the 40 he was looking for. I think he's a good option. He's much faster in game speed than he was in the 40. Trust me on that. KJ Hamler, another speed option. Didn't run at the combine. Brandon Ayuk, Devin Duvernay as well. There's some other speedy wide receiver players in this draft also. Now, if you want to go the physical wide receiver route, here's some free agent options on that front. Breshad Perriman, who had a breakout year with Tampa Bay. 6'2", 220 pounds. He could be an option. Paul Richardson, been banged up the past couple of years. If you want a cheap option who's still pretty young, he is out there. Devin Funch, the same deal. He's been banged up, but he has a pretty good history. Demaryius Thomas had a little bit of a bounce back last year. And then Dez Bryant, hey, he was working out with Pat Mahomes about a week ago, 10 days ago. Maybe bring him in for a tryout, see what he's got. Some wide receivers in the draft that are more on the physical side of things. Laviska Shenault, who did not run well at the combine, got a little banged up as well. I like him a lot. He's a physical player. T. Higgins, 6'4", 220. He's a possession wide receiver who has good speed as well. Denzel Mims, one of the big winners at the combine. He's a big physical guy, vertical player, and he ran really, really well in the 40. I was surprised by that. Michael Pittman Jr. ran pretty well as well. He's a big target. And then Brian Edwards, who did not run the 40 at the combine. He's about 6'4", 220 as well. Now, today's show is brought to you by BetDSI, the internet's number one sportsbook. You can bet on the XFL right now, NBA, college basketball, this stuff's all heating up. But if you're an NFL-only guy, don't worry. You can bet on win totals, projected win totals, for next season. Take the over on the Chiefs. I think we're in line for another special year. Go to chatsports.com/bet. Use that promo code NFL120 to get that 120% deposit bonus. Let's go to Tim Howe here. This is a fun, exciting option here. Can you imagine Derrick Henry in the backfield at the same time as Hill, Kelsey, Hardman, Watkins? Obviously, that's not going to happen, but oh my God, we would be unbeatable. I'm with you. It's not going to happen, but it's fun to talk about, right? The latest report, though, is that the Titans are going to franchise tag Derrick Henry. At least that's the way they are leaning, which means Ryan Tannehill becomes a free agent, which that's interesting with all the quarterback carouseling that could happen this offseason. He wants to be the highest paid running back in the NFL. He recently said Zeke's contract in Dallas would be the floor of what he wants to get. Good luck to King Henry on that front. Under the tag, $10.3 million is the projected money he would make. So team friendly for Tennessee. Not surprising that they decided to tag him, because if you can keep the NFL's leading rusher for just over $10 million, that's pretty good value. And he's been a great rusher the last couple of years. He's really taken off after not being great his first couple of years in the NFL. I don't love his pass-catching ability, though, which he improved on this year. That's still not his game. You see the question up on screen. Would Henry make this the best offense of all time? Type A for yes, type B for no. It's exciting to think about. The name sounds great. It's sexy, right? Oh, Derrick Henry in the Chiefs offense. I actually don't love his fit. Damian Williams can run wheel routes out of the backfield. Is Derrick Henry going to do that? The Chiefs don't need a premier physical bruising running back. That's not their offense. But if you disagree, type A for yes, type B for no. This is kind of the projected contract my guy Tom Downey threw together. 4 years, $56 million of 14 per year, which would be just under what Zeke got, pretty close in that Todd Gurley range. I don't think Henry's becoming the highest paid back. I just don't. Look, he had a great year last year, and when that happens when you're entering free agency, good for you, but I don't think someone's going to pay him $16 million per year, so I think he's more in that $14 million range. But just for fun, look at these offensive players. Henry, Hill, Kelsey, Hardman, Watkins. Those are some pretty good fantasy football options. Problem is, this isn't fantasy football. I don't think Derrick Henry, there's any chance he's going to be in Kansas City in 2020.